Well, Scott Bennett is a whistleblower. We'll look at his resume. Scott Bennett is a U.S. Army Specials Operation Officer, 11th Psychological Operations Battalion, Civil Affairs Psychological Operations Command, and a Global Psychological Warfare Counterterrorism Analyst. Formerly with defense contractor Booz Allen Hamilton. He received a direct commission as an officer held in top secret sensitive compartmentalized information, TS/CSI security clearance, and worked in the highest levels of international counterterrorism in Washington, D.C. and MacDill Air Force Base in Tampa, Florida. He has worked at U.S. Special Operations Command, U.S. Central Command, the State Department Coordinator for Counterterrorism, and other government agencies. He served the G.W. Bush administration from 2000 to 2008. And was a social science research fellow at the Heritage Foundation. His writings and lectures seek to enhance global awareness and understanding of modern psychological warfare, the international intelligence. And his site, Project Camelot, he wrote a book, Shell Game, a military whistleblowing report to the U.S. Congress, exposing the betrayal, yeah. And tonight he is up against the 130-pound Victoria, the Vixen Sharp, in this corner, ladies and gentlemen. She is an EMT. She is a Christian singer. She is probably the most unlucky woman in the world to go for a truck ride with a bunch of yahoos. Who knows? She was chaperoned by Shauna Cox, of course, but she's been having bad luck with the son-in-laws and stuff. But Victoria did get world famous and will get world rich over.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Scott Bennett and Michael J. We are bringing Truth Unite. February 3rd, 2016, we've got a special guest. We have got the warrior from Mockingjay, who gives the real life incarnate expression of character of what a woman warrior is. And that is the blessed and beautiful Victoria Sharp. And her story, of course, is miraculous, to say the least. It's nothing else but miraculous. And I'm so honored to have her and a very fine man we will term as Ghost, a fine military man, a fine special operation thinker. And someone is going to give us a briefing and a download for what's going on up there in Oregon and what they need and how we can help them, and a further analysis of the situation up there. Our Mockingjay warrior, Victoria, with the legal knowledge to wield her bow effectively, as well as Ghost defend up there. And I'm wearing my special operations hat, one of my own stomping grounds, in honor of Ghost and Victoria. We are in a fight, and we have the righteous God on our side. And I am reminded every day of the miraculous saving that Victoria went through as proof of that.
If he comes from that kind of trained, experienced, black ops, psychological operations, anti-terrorism, he had to interview Victoria Sharp. He was probably like Doom was when they told him he'd have to throw this one. Come on, that's hard. You want me to interview this Valley girl and make it seem like it's legitimate with all the background I have in psychological warfare? Come on, give me a break. Victoria Sharp, the EMT. Don't you think the EMT union or association or school of or something have a problem with you saying she's an EMT? She did nothing to help. She's not very intelligent. They should be like in the newspaper complaining. They should be like the Anti-Defamation EMT League. They probably have an agent that each different type of personality will identify with. They are bringing out all types of people trying to corner the majority of the people, that they have some kind of agent that this person is respectful of. That's pretty scary, playing the same role of Rebecca Roth. He's like the Mickey Roth version of Rebecca Roth, blaming the Mossad, working probably for the Mossad. Ken O'Keefe plays this kind of prodigal son, teardrop tattoo on his face, tattoos on his hands. James Dean, tough guy, but not by choice, wants to help out the underdog, kind of guy who rather be drinking beer out of the can than fighting, but he got a little touch of a healthy sense of spirituality. Ex-Marine, tough tat enough. He uses real curse words and sees through.
Control would be admirable. How many people can we name in any of these structures of power who've spoken out at high levels? I mean, the biggest, most stark example of somebody at a high level who actually spoke out, you know, there are other exceptions. There's another man in this room, Scott Bennett. Does anybody know who Scott Bennett is? Okay, there you go. But who knows who Julian Assange is? Right. Who knows who Edward Snowden is? Yeah, right. You should know about that man over there. That man is a real whistleblower. He's got balls that are bigger than, you know, most basketballs, I'd say. And he's ultimately, nobody really, well, people do, but, you know, we should all know who this man is. This man has the goods to prove that Hillary Clinton and Swiss banks directly finance what we know as ISIS. And yet you don't know this man, you know. So people who are compromised, you know, false opposition, controlled opposition, generally you'll hear their names. Like National Public Radio. Not once have I been invited on there. I mean, you know, whether you like me or not, I mean, why wouldn't you invite me on? Come on, challenge me on my shit. Come on, let's go. I can turn off the swear words and all that stuff. No problem, let's go. No, not once. So even the ones that you admire, you think, you know, are really open-minded and really pushing the dialogue and open debate and all that, bullshit. You know, the real people who are actually doing real honorable stuff, usually you won't even hear of them, and they don't get rewarded. The ones who have no morals, those are the ones who get rewarded. That's the world we've lived in, and it all comes back to the system. Fly money. They've bought everything and everyone. The world who actually...
He actually asks the audience if any of you are CIA agents. There's agents all over. So he turned around and he did some talks in America. He did not seem the type of person that would go to this event. That was all for our benefit. And anytime you have one of those weekends, weekday, week, whatever, for your group, the leaders all have pretty people of their choice around them and end up sleeping with people. That's the end of your movement. And you and Ivan, the investigator, get drunk until 3 in the morning and he pukes on you and you never met him before. But now you'll be YouTube buddies. You've got egotistical people there that like to have all the power and you're screwed. That has happened to every movement since people started to eat together. There are so many plants coming out now, agents trolling YouTube, controlling the alternative media. Very telling. He's an agent. Both of them are agents. Ken O'Keefe goes into how to spot an agent, and if the agent doesn't have much notoriety, probably not an agent, probably the real thing. Like he just said, Scott Bennett was. People don't know him enough, and he's the real thing, this ringing endorsement. I mean, Scott Bennett probably isn't the person that his resume says he is. He doesn't seem like he has that focused intensity. Somebody who could really psychologically take someone apart. But if he was, this person would be able to see past Victoria Sharp in about 2-3 seconds, most likely look her in the eye. This is ridiculous. That resume is one of the top people would be in the United States. They stole somebody's resume.
You go to the Get Smart agent school with agent 69, 99, 19, whoever you want to be. This is your first interview. If you could figure out whether Victoria Sharp is lying, everybody comes out laughing, thinking that's the extent of it.
shot him 3 more times. Bombarded our vehicle with bullets, flying gas us like 5 times. Their angle was bad, so they couldn't breathe. His hands were still up after he was dead. At least 120 shots. We showed no aggression at all. A ton of vehicles. There was full in the trees. Like, it was an ambush. It was a set-up ambush or something, because there was, like, people in the trees.
And then they tell you you might have to go to Lavoie. You might have to go to Wolfgang. Who knows? And you got a 50-50 chance. Lavoie probably developed that role for himself. He knew he could do it. He put in the application, can we have the hoax go out? And they said, yeah, Lavoie, we got faith in you, man. Like an actor that's going to be retiring soon and wants to get an Oscar, he looks for a special role that it would be perfect. He went to the party down in Mexico that the alternative media put on, and he was stopped at the border and not allowed to go in.
So I'm here at LAX. I was meant to fly into Acapulco for the Anarchapulco conference, but that's not happening. So what fucking ever. I flew into LAX yesterday, dealt with the same old bullshit. So today I was to fly out, and lo and behold, I went to get on the flight, and the normal procedure is TSA, Homeland Security, those fucking jokers. Basically, they, you know, check through everything, and they follow me in the airport. They literally follow me into the toilets when I'm in the U.S. It is a fucking joke. Keep in mind, I'm an ex-U.S. Marine. I served in the first Gulf War, and daughters ordered to take experimental drugs. No different from what Adolf Hitler is accused of doing, experimenting on Jews and gypsies and all the rest. The U.S. government did that because the food and drug had feeling me up, feeling my balls and these fucking body scanners, aside from taking a picture of you perfectly naked through all your clothes and whatnot, are dousing you with bullshit that is, you can bank, is not good for you. My ass and all that sort of shit, so they can be sure that I'm not carrying dangerous weapons up my ass and around my fucking body. But apparently that's not enough. The Homeland Security TSA has now, I refused. Therefore, I am now technically unable to leave the United States by air travel unless I consent to this. Go fuck yourself. They're basically doing what they gotta do, although that's what the Nazis did according to the official history, just following orders. But nonetheless, I treat them with respect even though I don't appreciate what they're being ordered to do. I want you to tell your bosses, go fuck yourself. Fuck off from me. And I will not consent to your bullshit. Here I am back in Homeland fucking Securityville, the United States, the jokers that are basically carrying out Israeli Jewish orders. For now, I'm actually stuck in the United States. I will not consent to a body scan. And ultimately, I'm not crying, you know, woe is me. I really, you know, this stuff motivates me. But honestly, I say enough, really. You know, again, I repeat, according to the official version of history, the Nazis on the lower ranking end were just following orders. What is the difference? Just about had it with this fucking bollocks. I think it's the last time I enter this godforsaken country. Really, enough is enough. I am disgusted by the activities of my birth nation in so-called homeland. Fucking disgrace.
So, he was kept out of Mexico. Here's, he's refusing the body scan. So he does a fuck the USSA TSA Homeland Security tour after the Archipelago Akanaka Sakalaka conference. And he raises all this money and he tours the U.S. on this fuck the USA TSA. I don't think you can do this. I've never seen you having curse words and having them on posters across the country because you're coming to speak. Really, you'd think most the sheriffs and the local police would say, nah, you're not putting that up there, dude, and don't play with the American flag. Here he is, he toured all over. He raised all the money he can. He was begging for money everywhere he went. There's about 20 of these videos of him on this tour. Problem is, he went into Toronto. How did he get into Canada? So, supposedly, he was getting away from America and he went to England, like our best ally. Really? Could have went to Israel. You got Boland, who's in Sweden, our freaking good ally. And you got Ryan Dawson in Japan, our good ally. Okay. So he got involved in this. Problem is that he did somehow get down to Anarchapulco, Lapuco, and he took part in it. He doesn't mention that. from what I can tell, he got there from out of the country somewhere with Max Egan. They flew into Mexico. That's the best I can see. If he took a train or bus, a bus is 2 days and a train is like 8 hours to get there. Max Egan is his friend and involved in this whole thing, and they had some disagreement, yada, yada, yada. That's the deal, Lucille. He makes it seem like he turned around in LAX and did this tour of fuck the USA, TSA. You know, if you support him, you just think it was kind of, he forgot. It's awful hokey. Awful hokey. The whole thing with that male bride looking chick that he hooked up with, and that whole thing with raising money. You think about it yourself, okay? How did he get into Mexico? By train to Acapulco, and then he got back into the U.S. He toured cursing the country, and then he went and they let him into Canada. They let him back into the U.S., and then they had him leave the U.S. Okay. It all sounds good to me.